A link and V link. As you know, the hyperlinks are the highlighted text segments or images that connect to other pages on the web. When you hover your mouse pointer over the link, it gets highlighted and the shape of the pointer changes. By default, the hyperlinks are underlined and have a specific color according to their active, unvisited, and visited state. The hyperlinks are created using the anchor tag with href attribute specifying the path of the document to be linked. For example, consider the following code to create a hyperlink on a web page. href://www.yahoo.co.in, home page of Yahoo, /a. By including the above code in your HTML document, you will get home page of Yahoo displaying on the web page. Observe this text in a hyperlink, underlined in blue. Setting link colors. The link, A link and V link attributes of the body tag controls the colors of the hyperlinks displayed on the web page. Link attribute. This attribute specifies the color of the unvisited links in the web page. The default color set by this attribute is blue. The colors used for the link should be in contrast with the background of the web page so that the links are highlighted. Example, body link equals to double quote in green, double quote close. A link attribute. When you close the website that has been opened using a link, and now if you go and see the link, you will find that it will be in purple. It means that the website connected to the link has already been opened using the link. Whenever you open the website containing the link, until the history is erased, the V link is appeared in purple only. Example, body A link equals to double quote in hash FF00FF double quote close. V link attribute. The V link attribute defines the color of the link after it has been visited. When you close the website that has been opened using a link, and if you go and see the link, you will see that it will be in purple color. It means that the website connected to the link has already been opened using the link. Example, body V link equals to double quote in hash FFAA00 double quote close. Setting margins. Margins refer to the blank space left from the edge of the page. HTML provides facilities to set margins as per your desire. Top margin. The top margin attribute is used to set the top margin from the edge of a web page. It is given in the body tag. It accepts value in pixels, which makes the body text appear according to the number of specified pixels away from the top edge of the page. Syntax. Body top margin equals to double quote in value double quote close. Left margin. The left margin attribute is used to set the left margin of a web page by leaving some blank area in the left side. Like top margin, it is also given in body tag with any value in pixels. The value accordingly keeps the text away from the left edge of a page. Syntax. Body left margin equals to double quote in value double quote close. Let me share a tip with you. In the same way, we can also set right margin and bottom margin by using the right margin and bottom margin attributes in the body tag. Students, let us now talk about empty elements. Some elements in HTML are forbidden from containing any content at all. These are known as empty or void elements. These elements contain only the starting tag and perform some specific functions on their own. For example, BR, HR, link and meta tags. There are three ways to write empty elements. Only specify the start tag. It is the most common way of writing empty elements. Example, BR, HR, ING. Do not enclose any data between the start tag and the end tag. Example, BR. This is a sample code. Note, here no closing tag is required. Another way to write the empty tags is in the form of self-closing tags. Make sure to leave one space and insert a slash forward slash symbol after the tag name. Example, this is a sample code, BR slash. Let us discuss some commonly used empty elements in HTML. BR tag. This tag breaks a line and displays the preceding text in the next line without giving any space between the two lines. It should be given at the end of that line, after which a new line is required. Syntax BR. HR tag. The HR tag is used as a separator between the blocks of text. It adds a horizontal rule spread across the width of the browser window. This tag inserts a line break similar to BR tag. The BR tag retains the previously set alignment of the paragraph. However, the HR tag changes the alignment of a paragraph to its default alignment, that is, left. Syntax HR. The attributes of HR tag are given below. Size. Specifies the thickness of line in terms of pixels. A pixel is equal to dividing an inch into 72 points. The default size of the horizontal rule is 3 pixels. You can change the size of the horizontal rule when needed. Example, HR size equals to 4. Width specifies the length of line. The value can be given either in pixels or percentage. Example, HR width equals to 25%. Align specifies the alignment of line. Alignment can be set to right, left or center. Example, HR align equals to double quote in left, double quote close. No shade produces an unshaded dark gray line. Example, HR no shade. Color, it is used to set the color of line. Example, HR color equals to double quote in blue, double quote close. Let us discuss character entities. Some characters are reversed in HTML. To display such reverse characters, we use the character's entities in the HTML source code. And LT. This entity displays less than sign on the browser. And GT. This entity displays greater than sign on the browser. and AMP. This entity displays the and sign on the browser. These signs, smaller, greater, and have special meaning in HTML. If you want to display these symbols on a web page, they are to be written in the given syntax. And NBSP is a special character entity used to insert blank spaces. It is used in the body element. Number of spaces inserted is equal to the number of times the special character is repeated. Observe that the AND NBSP entity has a semicolon at the end. First, let's start with list in HTML. A list is the most efficient way of presenting information in a precise manner.